One of Mark Twain's famous quotes is that no man's life, liberty, or property are safe while the legislature is in session. And if we look back at the history of Guam legislature, if we look at the end of the 32nd legislature, when it went into a lame duck session, they passed their pay raise bill in secret. They also tried to pass a bill giving Guam Recovery Resource Partners a waste energy contract. But because that was a publicly heard bill, the public stood up and it did not pass. And now we're here facing the debt bomb. Bill 390, $100 million tax refund, but even more dangerous is Bill 363, a bill that legalizes waste energy. And we need look no further to see what the problem is than to go to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
You know, Frederica, the interesting part about this situation for Harrisburg is that you'd think that they're in this predicament because of the recession or the slowing economy, but that's really not the case. You know, Harrisburg filed for bankruptcy because of a trash incinerator, of all things, because this trash incinerator was basically built on borrowed funds and continued to be updated and upgraded on borrowed funds as well. It put the city of Harrisburg in the hole, I'm talking debt-wise, to the tune of $310 million, and Harrisburg found itself unable to pay for its debt. So it went ahead and voted a few days ago to go ahead and file for bankruptcy.
That's right, bankruptcy. And now Governor Calvo has signed a deal with Guam Recovery Resource Partners that will allow him to build our own debt bomb. Waste energy plant. But we need to think about this for a second, because we need to protect the financial integrity of Government of Guam, because one in three paychecks is a Government of Guam paycheck. And right now, Government of Guam is financially fragile. The government is having a hard time paying its bills, and the government right now is $1.5 billion in debt when you look at the retirement fund as well as other outstanding bonds. For the past 3 years, we've run a fiscal deficit. We're probably somewhere between $120 and $180 million in debt on operations, and we keep making bad decisions. Government of Guam just recently selected the most expensive health care option, which will cost taxpayers an additional $21 million a year. In fact, the financial situation at Government of Guam is so fragile, the Department of Administration had to transfer child support money to cover payroll a couple of months back. And Department of Education has had a couple of scares, which is bad when you consider they're the largest government agency. So, Dennis Rodriguez will tell you, and anybody who asks, that Bill 363 is not a waste energy bill. But when you look in the definitions of the bill, you see this. Renewable energy means energy produced or generated using the following sources, and we go down to number 7. Solid municipal waste and other solid waste. And I know it's a semantics, it's just words, but when you consider how words got us into the situation with Guam YTK. Yeah, Guam YTK. Yes, we're going to talk about it. Because the same language that we see in Bill 363 is the kind of language that got us into trouble as citizens over the Guam YTK issue. It was a poorly written contract that could potentially end up putting between $14 and $20 million taxpayer dollars in the hands of the owners. And that's not the only situation. We have a loophole in the law to rebuild Simon Sanchez. We could see $100, $200, $300 million pass through that loophole, and you and I will be the ones that have to pay that burden. So when you add Guam YTK, Simon Sanchez, and then you throw on top of that Bill 390, $100 million for a tax refund for 1 year, and Bill 363, $350 million to build a waste energy plant. That could add another $4,000 to the backs of every man, woman, and child on Guam. That's a hell of a debt load for everyone to carry. And that debt load could be enough to trigger the debt bomb. Yeah. And I say that because it's not just the cost of the facility. Based on numbers given to us by the federal receivers supervising the landfill, and the numbers, he analyzed the numbers given to him by GRRP on this project, and it looks like if this project is built, government of Guam will go an additional $76 to $80 million a year in the red, just on the landfill operation. When you consider we're running $40 to $60 million a year in the red on all other operations, that could be enough to cause the President of the United States to appoint a federal management team for Guam to supervise all financial transactions by our government. So, that's why this lame duck session is very, very critical for us as taxpayers. Because on Bill 363, it's already had a hearing. And right now, Senator Atta is trying to determine if he's going to put it on the floor for a vote. And the reason this is dangerous is because when you look at the sponsors on Bill 363, we see that we've eliminated six of the sponsors. So there's hope for us to prevent the debt bomb from triggering if we can convince Senator Tom Atta not to put this bill on the floor during the lame duck session. And I would like to conclude this presentation with a quote from Angela Davis, who was a community activist back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. And her famous quote is, "I am no longer accepting things I cannot change. I am changing things I cannot accept." I got involved in this fight because I could not accept the fact that my children and great-grandchildren were going to be carrying the type of debt that would crush their futures for the rest of their lives. That's why I got involved. I'm encouraging each and every one of you watching this video to take a couple of minutes to do your duty as citizens. We already saw how powerful that is with this past election. Take a couple of minutes and send an email to Senator Tom Atta. Here's his address. And tell him you do not want to see Bill 363 on the floor for a vote in the November or the December sessions. That's all you have to do. And if enough of us send that email, I'm very sure that Senator Tom Atta will take into consideration the lessons learned by six members of the Gang of Eight, and he will respect the desires of the public. But he won't know if you don't email. So, like this video, share this video, and send Senator Tom Atta an email and tell him no more debt in the 33rd legislature. Thank you.